morning, and we're gonna go fire up our Rec Tech grill at 225 so we can make some ribs for the Talladega race. As that gets going, we're gonna go prepare our ribs. All right, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna prepare the surface. It's gonna be easy to clean and throw away after we're done rubbing the ribs together. So we do that. The larger one over the smaller one, I guess. What we've got, two racks of Louisiana style ribs from the local grocery store. And while I clean these up and rinse them off, we'll come back. Peeling the membrane right now, and supposedly it makes the ribs more tender. Get under them. All the videos I've seen come right off just like that. Alright, so I've got the membrane peeled off. Got these dry a little bit. Get some of the extra water off. What I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use some yellow mustard. Water running. Wash my fingers afterwards. I'll rub these down with some yellow mustard. I don't know if yellow mustard is the right thing to do or not. I've seen it. I've seen butter used. I don't know if any of it matters. First, we're going to use some Ben's Bangin' Brisket Rub. And then some Honey Rib Rub. Back side, so I'm not going to overdo it. Put these bad boys over. Split my ribs right there. First time I'm doing St. Louis spare ribs. I've done the baby back style ribs before, but not these. They're actually quite a bit cheaper here. So what we're going to do is we're going to let those sit for about a half an hour, and you'll start to see, you can already start to see the shine coming through where the rub is pulling the moisture up out of the meat. So we're going to let those get this nice glaze on them. Take about a half an hour, and what I just did is I wiped down everything that I handled. I washed up. You want to be careful, it's pork, you don't want to get anybody sick. So everything's cleaned up. We're gonna go out and get the amazing smoker going. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna get my tube smoker going. And what I do is I fill that up
with about 50-50 cherry wood chips and the pellets from the back of the smoker. We're gonna get that going. My wife thinks that everything should have a little bit more smoke flavor in it, so this will help the Rec-Tec grill give her that. What we're going to do is we're going to get this going. And this thing needs to get going for about 10 minutes before you blow it out and put it on the grill so that it will burn. And you get about 3.5-4 hours of smoke out of it. Been going for a while. We're gonna blow it out. Look at the smoke that comes from that smoke tube. Like I said, that's filled 50-50 with pellets and wood cherry wood chips. I'm gonna take these pliers. You'll start to see how much smoke that really gives. You're gonna start to see the smoke really bellow out of this thing now. After putting that smoker tube in there, good smoke. I got my ready check set. I have a slight variance between the Rec-Tec temperature and the ready check temperature, so I've actually increased the Rec-Tec up to 235, and that's gonna be 225 on my ready check. I don't know why there's a variance, but there is. So, because we're making ribs, we won't be using the meat probe, and we'll be back shortly. So our ribs are ready. You can actually see the juices are starting to actually puddle up from the rubs. There's a puddle there, and there's some puddle in there. So we're going to go ahead and put this thing on. Okay, so when I said last time that I would see you in 3 hours, that's not without spritzing at 1.5 hours. I'm just going to spritz these down with some apple juice. Plenty of smoke going on in there. And that's it. We'll see you in 1.5 hours. Alright, so it's been the 3 hours. We're going to pull these off the grill. We're going to bring them inside, wrap them in foil. Add a little apple juice, bring them back out, put it back on for 2 hours. Oh yeah. Okay, let's go wrap them up. All right, we're gonna take these. Laid out my aluminum foil to wrap them ahead of time. I have apple juice and a ramekin here. I'm just gonna pour it down the side here. Let's pour some on this side too. And that'll help steam them up. Alright, so we're going to put this back on the grill, wrapped in aluminum foil for 2 hours. Make sure we got a good seal. My amazing tube smoker is still going. It's been a little over 3 hours now. We're going to let that go for 2 hours in the delightful rain that we have here in New England. Alright, so we're back out here in the rain. The ribs have been on for 2 hours. Wrapped in foil. I'm going to take them off. I'm
Those are actually looking really good. Pulling away real nice. So we're gonna put some Sweet Baby Ray's on. I got the honey barbecue. I like them pretty saucy, so put those on. Little brush here. You want to be light so you don't move around your rub. You don't want to be peeling that up. So we're gonna squeeze those over real good. Turn this around. And open up this like that. Oh yeah. Those. So we're gonna sauce these bad boys. And then we're gonna put them back on the grill for about an hour. Not covered. Alright, so now we're just going to put these back on the grill. Our Rec Tech and Smoke. Said we're going to do that for about an hour, and then we will have ribs to watch the Talladega race. All right, so we're going to pull those ribs a little bit early because of how they looked when I took them out of the aluminum foil. I put them back on for half an hour. They've got to be done. I think they're going to be great. At this point, I know you're really going to want to dig into them, but you really should let them rest 10-15 minutes. We'll see you then. All right, so we're going to take these off, put them on our cutting board. I think they look pretty good. We're going to cut the middle rib out.
That's my plate.
Steve.
Look at that.
No, I don't want that one.
Oh.
It tender?
Mmm. Here you go, Grandma. I'll cut you one right now.
I don't mean hot, hot.
Here you go, Grandma.
Thank you.
Try that and tell me what you think.
Thank you, Ricky. Oh, I'll try it over here. My big
try your first bite and tell us what you think.
Mmm. Oh, delicious. Where'd you buy these?
So thank you for watching my video, and thank you to my camera woman, my smoking hot wife, Shauna, and we look forward to seeing you again.